मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस नविदा शेख फ्रॉम बृहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका MCGM वर्चुअल क्लास. आई वेलकम ऑल माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू अनदर एन इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लर्निंग समथिंग न्यू एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फ्रॉम अ साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक. सो लेट्स गेट. गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस नविदा शेख फ्रॉम MCGM वर्चुअल क्लास. Welcome all my dear students to another and interesting session. In today's class, we will be learning a very interesting chapter, that is chemical equations and reactions. Now, this chapter is very important because it will help you understand how to write down equation, how to balance them, and what are the different types of reaction that actually take place. And if you pay attention in this particular video, you will be having a clear concept of all the coming equations that you will be having in the next coming few chapters. Okay, so that is why you need to be very attentive during this class. So let's get started. In your earlier standards, we have seen how compounds are formed by chemical combination of elements. In your 8th standard, you have learned about how elements form compounds and how do they react with each other. We have also learned that the driving forces behind formation of chemical bond is to attain an electronic configuration, means in order to complete the octet. Octet kya aa raha aap logo ko, hum logo ne electronic configuration padhe the about the atom, jahan par uska outermost shell complete hona chahiye, aur jab wo complete kaise hota hai, because of the chemical bonds between the elements. Okay, in order to attain the electronic configuration, the atoms attain a complete octet by giving, taking or sharing of electrons with each other. We have also seen this, how the electrons are donated, how they accept electrons or they share electrons and form bonds with each other. This is all that we have already learned. So what are we going to learn in today's class? So I was talking about how physical and chemical changes are important for us to understand in order to get to the chemical equation and chemical reaction. So a physical change takes place due to change in the parameters such as temperature and pressure. जो बाहर के जो factors है, like temperature है, pressure है, इसके वजह से physical changes occur होते हैं. Often a physical change is reversible. लाइक आई विल टेक अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ कैंडल. अगर हम लोग कैंडल को मेल्ट करते हैं तो वो जो कैंडल वैक्स में कन्वर्ट हो रही है वो एक फिजिकल चेंज है. वो वैक्स को फिर से हम लोग कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं, कैंडल बना सकते हैं. सो इट इज अ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस. द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ मैटर रिमेन्स द सेम इन फिजिकल चेंज. मतलब अगर वो कैंडल वैक्स से बना था तो वैक्स ही रहेगा, वो कुछ और सब्सटेंस नहीं बनेगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आइस इज ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इन टू वाटर ऑन हीटिंग एंड वाटर इज ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इन टू आइस ऑन कूलिंग. On contrary, if composition of matter changes during a process, then it is called a chemical change. ठीक है, तो वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल इज आइस. आइस को अगर हम लोग मेल्ट करेंगे तो क्या फॉर्म हो जाता है? वाटर. वाटर को अगर हम लोग फिर से कूल करेंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा? वो फिर से आइस बन जाएगा. तो इसमें फिजिकल चेंज हो रहा है, कोई नया प्रोडक्ट नहीं फॉर्म हो रहा है, सिर्फ उसका स्टेट बदलता है. ठीक है, ऑन दी अदर हैंड, अगर कुछ नया फॉर्म हो रहा है रिएक्शन के वजह से, लाइक रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन, एक नया प्रोडक्ट बन रहा है, तो वो है केमिकल चेंज. व्हेन वी कॉल अ पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस ऑफ फिनोमेना एज अ केमिकल चेंज, सम केमिकल रिएक्शंस आर टेकिंग प्लेस इन द कंसर्न्ड मैटर. ठीक है, तो रिमेंबर दीज सिंपल एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन और फर्मेंटेशन. दिस विल हेल्प यू रिमेंबर केमिकल चेंजेस. A chemical reaction is a process in which some substances undergo bond breaking and are transformed into new substances by formation of new bonds. ठीक है, तो chemical reaction के अंदर अक्सर there is bond breaking, मतलब दो substance को हम लोग जब use करते हैं in order to produce a new product, तो वहां पर bond breaking होती है. ठीक है, they undergo some changes and a new substance is formed with new bonds. All right. The substances taking part in chemical reactions are called reactants, whereas the substance formed as a result of a chemical change reaction by formation of new bonds are called products. For example, formation of carbon dioxide gas by combustion of coal in air is a chemical reaction. ठीक है, जब हम लोग कोल को जलाते हैं एयर की प्रेजेंस में तो जो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस बन रहा है दैट इज दिस ऑल थिंग इज कॉल्ड अ केमिकल रिएक्शन दैट इज एक्चुअली हैपनिंग। ठीक है, तो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस रिलीज हो रही है, एक नया प्रोडक्ट रिलीज हो रहा है, व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ द बर्निंग ऑफ कोल। ठीक है, इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एयर। In this reaction, coal, that is carbon and oxygen from air are the reactants, while carbon dioxide is the product. Okay? A chemical reaction is represented by writing a chemical equation. तो chemical reaction को इतना बड़ा अगर हम लोग को statement लिखना पड़ेगा तो बहुत time consume होता है. तो there were methods of writing down the chemical reaction in the form of chemical equations. So we will be learning about that in detail in today's class. So today's class we'll be learning about what is chemical reaction. Now, simple terms, a chemical reaction is in which the bonds are broken within the reactant molecules and new bonds are formed within the product molecule in order to form a new substance. Means reactant मतलब जो चीज हम लोग दो product को जब हम लोग react करते हैं उससे जो हम लोगों को final product मिलता है, जो दो प्रोडक्ट हम लोग ने इनिशियली स्टार्ट किए थे जिससे रिएक्शन करने के लिए, उसे रिएक्टेंट कहते हैं। और वो जब दोनों रिएक्ट करते हैं तो जो हम लोग को एंड प्रोडक्ट मिलता है उसे हम लोग प्रोडक्ट कहते हैं। ठीक है, इन ऑर्डर टू फॉर्म अ न्यू सब्सटेंस, तो जो प्रोडक्ट मिला है वो न्यू सब्सटेंस फॉर्म हो जाता है रिएक्टेंट्स के वजह से। केमिकल रिएक्शन इज हैपनिंग ऑल अराउंड अस, फ्रॉम द मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ फूड इन योर बॉडी टू हाउ द लाइट वी गेट फ्रॉम द सन इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस। Before beginning with chemical reaction, it is important to know about physical and chemical changes. Basic concepts of chemical reaction that we all need to know before starting the chapter. A chemical reaction is a process that occurs when two or more molecules interact to form a new product. Means I need to have two or more than two molecules which are coming together to react. Okay, they interact with each other and they form a new product. Compounds that interact to produce new compounds are called reactants. Suppose if I have a compound and if it is combining together to form a new substance, that new substance is called as the product. Whereas jo cheez hum log ke interact ho rahi hai, jo compounds interact ho rahe hain, usse hum log reactants kehte hain. Chemical reactions play an integral role in different industries, customs, and even in our daily life. They are continuously happening in our general surroundings. For example, rusting of iron, pottery, fermentation of wine, and so on. We have learned about all these things in our previous classes as well. Rusting of iron, तो हम लोग के घर में हम लोग देखते ही हैं. You must have seen कि किस तरीके से अगर कोई nail है, खिल्ला रखा हुआ है बाहर, या कोई भी ऐसी चीज लोखंड की चीज अगर बाहर रखी होती है जिधर मॉइस्चर मिल रहा है उसे, उसके वजह से वहां पे जंग लग जाता है। वो जंग कैसे लग रहा है, हम लोगों को दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है, ये कैसे हो रहा है? दिस इज ऑल केमिकल रिएक्शन दैट इज एक्चुअली हैपनिंग। ओके, फर्मेंटेशन, जो हम लोग इडली वगैरह बनाते हैं, वाइन तो भी हम लोग घर में नहीं बनाते, बट आई एम गिविंग अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन ऑफ मिल्क, और वेन यू आर मेकिंग नॉर्मल इडलीज एंड डोसा उसमें फर्मेंटेशन होता है, तो वो भी केमिकल रिएक्शन हो रहा है उनके अंदर, तभी हम लोगों को एक नया प्रोडक्ट मिलता है। इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन अ केमिकल चेंज मस्ट अकर व्हिच इज जनरली ऑब्जर्व्ड विद फिजिकल चेंजेस लाइक प्रेसिपिटेशन, हीट प्रोडक्शन, कलर चेंज एटसेट्रा। अ रिएक्शन कैन टेक प्लेस बिटवीन टू एटम्स और आयन्स और मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड दे फॉर्म अ न्यू बॉन्ड एंड नो एटम इज डिस्ट्रॉयड और क्रिएटेड बट अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट इज फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम द रिएक्शन। You should always remember, जब दो reactants combine होते हैं साथ में तो एक नया product बनता है। इसमें ना ही reactant खत्म हो जाता है ना ही product, ठीक है, reactant से ही product बन रहा है, तो वो energy हमेशा maintain रहती है। The rate of reaction depends on and is affected by factors like pressure, temperature, the concentration of the reactants. मतलब reactant कितना strong है या कितना dilute है उसके ऊपर depend करता है reaction हमारा, या फिर प्रेशर अंडर प्रेशर उसी के वो रिएक्शन हो रहा है, या फिर टेम्परेचर के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, कभी कभार हाई टेम्परेचर लगता है रिएक्शंस को, ठीक है, और अगर रिएक्शंस को टेम्परेचर सही नहीं मिलता तो वो जल्दी नहीं होते, डिले। सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर द फैक्टर्स दैट अफेक्ट द रेट ऑफ। सो इन टुडेज क्लास वी शुड बी एबल टू क्लासिफाई reactions by type, write a balanced molecular equation. You should be able to predict products of reactions given the chemical names of the reactants. Now you have to remember what are we going to study in this chapter. Chemical reactions. We will be learning about chemical equations, balancing chemical equations, predicting products from reactants. Then we will be learning about chemical equations type. Decomposition reactions, single replacement, double replacement, combustion, synthesis. These are the types of chemical reactions that actually takes place. Okay. So we will be learning a few from these chemical equations. Let us understand about chemical reactions now. So describing a chemical reaction, there are a few things that we need to keep in mind. Indication of a chemical reaction. There will be evolution of heat, light or sound. ठीक है? Production of a gas will be there. हम लोग कोई चीज जलाते हैं, अगर chemical reaction होगा तो वहां पर either heat निकले, heat generate होगी या light generate होगी या sound आएगा हम लोगों को और gas will be produced, धुआं निकलेगा. Formation of a precipitate means जब वो reaction हो जाएगा तो कुछ चीज नीचे residue के form में बच जाएगी. Like here, you can see this is what is precipitate. Color changes can take place. Here, so there are a few signs of chemical reactions. There are five main signs that indicate a chemical reaction has taken place. First one is change in color. So there will be a change in color. It will indicate that there is a chemical reaction taking place. Next is change in odor, means there will be smell produced. Any kind of smell it could be. ठीक है, तो there will be change in odor. Production of new gas or vapor. कुछ नई gas और vapors form होती है तो वो दिखाई देती है. Input or release of energy. Either it will absorb energy or it will give out energy. It is difficult to reverse a chemical reaction. Remember this. Now, a very simple example is a mango. Mango, जब हम लोग खाते हैं, जब वो season होता है उसका, तो you get raw mangoes also that are green in color. Over the period of time, they turn into yellow color and orange color, and then you can eat it. Can you make that yellow color mango again, fully ripe mango, into a raw mango? No. So it is a chemical change that is actually happening over there, which we cannot reverse it. जैसे कि हम लोग ने कैंडल के केस में किए थे, कैंडल अगर मेल्ट हो जाती है तो फिर से वो वैक्स से नई कैंडल बन सकती है, तो वो फिजिकल चेंज है. बट केमिकल रिएक्शन जब होते हैं तो उसमें वापस से वो प्रोडक्ट रिएक्टेंट नहीं फॉर्म कर सकता. ठीक है, सो इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू रिवर्स द रिएक्शन. लाइक एजिंग ऑल्सो, राइट? हम लोग जब छोटे होते हैं तो from that age till now, can you all become small again? Can you all become small babies again? No. So this is also a type of chemical reaction that is happening in our body. Chemical equations, they depict the kind of reactants and products and their relative amount in a reaction. ठीक है, अभी हम लोग समझ रहे हैं, अभी chemical equation समझ में आ गया कि chemical रिएक्शंस क्या होते हैं. अब हम लोग केमिकल इक्वेशंस को समझेंगे कि किस तरीके से उसके अंदर क्या क्या चीजें हैं और क्या उसका मतलब है. ठीक है, सो हियर देयर इज अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जांपल, एल्युमिनियम प्लस ऑक्सीजन विच गिव्स यू Al2O3. ओके, दैट इज एल्युमिनियम ऑक्साइड. Now here they both are combining, these are called as the reactants. Okay, aluminium and oxygen, they are the reactants that are combining together and reacting to give you a product. This is aluminium oxide is nothing but the new product which has been formed from the reactants. Got it? The letters S that you see, G that you see, okay, are L that you see are the physical states of compounds that they are showing. Here the letters like S shows that the aluminium is in the solid state, oxygen is in the gaseous state. Alright, and if there is L mentioned, then it means it is in the liquid state. ठीक है, तो reactants और products के साथ में ये letters भी चलते हैं equations के अंदर, तो हम लोग को समझ में आता है कि whether it is a solid, liquid or gas which was involved in the reaction. Because of the same atoms are present in a reaction, at the beginning reactants and at the end products, the amount of matter in a system does not change. मतलब जितना हम लोग रिएक्टेंट्स यूज करेंगे उतना ही हम लोग को प्रोडक्ट भी मिलेगा, ठीक है, एंड प्रोडक्ट भी उतना ही मिलेगा. तो यहाँ पर क्वांटिटी इज नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज, द अमाउंट ऑफ मैटर इज नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज बिकॉज द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मैटर. सो दिस इज द व्हाट वी आर स्टडिंग. जितना आएगा, ठीक है, जितना हम लोग रिएक्टेंट यूज करेंगे, इट विल अंडरगो केमिकल चेंजेस एंड देन that much amount of product will be formed. ठीक है, it could be in different states, it could be but remember both the sides will always be the same amount. वो bifurcate भी हो सकता है, it could be 80% 20%, suppose if I am getting two products, but the amount will be balance करेंगे जब दोनों को, तो वो it will be equal to the amount of reactants that were used during the reaction. Because of the principle of conservation of matter, an equation must be balanced. Okay, whenever we are writing down the equation has to be balanced because of the conservation law of conservation of the matter. It must have the same number of atoms of the same kind on both the sides. The equation must be represented, and you should know few facts. The equation must represent known facts, means जो भी हमारे पास data है reactants का और products का, वो बराबर तरीके से represent करेगा. The equation must contain the correct formulas for the reactants and products. ठीक है, there will be formulas involved. You have learned about the symbols of the elements, and that we are going to use in this chapter. So if you do not know, please go home, go through all the names and the symbols of the elements that you have learned up till now, so that when we are studying this part, it will be clear to you. The law of conservation of mass must be satisfied, means both the sides should have same amount of matter and it should be balanced. Reactants. Now, what are reactants? The substances that exist before a chemical change or reaction which takes place. Those are called as reactants. मतलब जब हम लोग कोई चीज, जैसे हम लोगों ने previous example देखे थे, aluminium plus oxygen, they both were reactants. Alright? Now, what is the meaning of products? The new substances that are formed during the chemical change are known as the products. What is a chemical equation? The chemical equation indicates the reactants and the products of a reaction. मतलब वो हम लोग को बताता है कि reactants क्या है और products क्या form हो रहे हैं with the help of the arrow. Now remember, the arrow also plays a very important part in writing down the chemical equation. I'll be explaining all that as well. Let's understand the meaning of chemical formula. Chemical symbol सबको पता है, ठीक है, दैट इज सपोज इफ आई एम टेकिंग वाटर, तो वाटर का केमिकल सिंबल है H2O. मीनिंग ऑफ दिस सिंबल इज वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ वाटर, मींस H2O के आगे कोई नंबर नहीं दिया है, तो वो एक मॉलिक्यूल है वाटर का. ठीक है, कॉम्पोजिशन मींस उसके अंदर क्या क्या एटम्स है, कौन से मॉलिक्यूल्स इन्वॉल्व है. देर आर टू हाइड्रोजन एटम्स एंड वन ऑक्सीजन एटम. यू कैन सी H2O. H2 मींस हाइड्रोजन कितने एटम्स प्रेजेंट है, दो एटम्स, एंड ऑक्सीजन का वन एटम. व्हेन दे कंबाइन टुगेदर दे गिव यू अ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल. नाउ हियर आई हैव टू H2O, दीज आर टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर, राइट. सो How many hydrogen atoms do I have here now? I have 4 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms. Here, H2O2, one molecule of hydrogen peroxide. Here, if you notice, how many hydrogen do I have? I have 2 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms. Now, pay attention to this, what I am marking. Now, if you notice here, this 2 that we are talking about, this 2 gets multiplied with this H also and this O as well. Okay? Clear everybody? So, it is important for you all to remember. Tabhi aap logo samajh mein aa raha hoga ki ye 4 hydrogen atoms aur 2 oxygen atoms kaise aaye. Right? So let us understand some additional symbols which we are using in chemical equations. This arrow that you see, you do not have arrow head on both the sides. You have arrow head only onto the right hand side. Now what does it mean? This means that it yields indicates results of reaction. Matlab it is showing the reaction is going in which direction. If the arrows are mentioned like this, means one onto the reaction side and one on the product side. That means the reaction is reversible. It is used to indicate a reversible reaction. Like in the case of water. Okay, solid ko hum log liquid bana sakte hai, liquid ko hum log phir se solid bana sakte hai. So that way it is a reversible reaction ke andar hum log is tarike ki symbol ko use karte hain. S indicates a reactant or product in the solid state, also used to indicate a precipitate. Matlab jab koi reaction hota hai aur kuch cheez solid jaisi cheez bach jati hai reaction ke baad, to use hum log precipitate kehte hain. This arrow which is pointing downwards, it is used as an alternative to show S, but used only to indicate a precipitate. Matlab agar koi reaction mein, mostly after the reaction when the product is formed, if there is a precipitate being formed, theek hai, matlab ek aisa solution ke andar chalky type ya kuch bhi aisa solute residue bach gaya hai, banta hai, to wo show karne ke liye hum log ye arrow use karte hain. L is used to indicate the liquid state, whether a product or a reactant. In both the cases L hum log batate hain as a liquid state. AQ means the aqueous solution, a reactant or a product in a aqueous solution. That means it has been dissolved in water. Suppose if I have sodium chloride and water. Sodium chloride is salt, and if I'm dissolving it, water. So that makes an aqueous solution. G indicates a reactant or product in the gaseous state. There are a few more symbols that we need to know. This arrow that you see, that is pointing towards the upward direction, it shows that there is a release of gas. Okay, it is an alternative to gas, but used only to indicate a gaseous product. Next, you can see a triangle being mentioned. That means it is a reactant. The reactants are heated. Means if there are there is water, suppose if I have ice cube, I'm heating it in order to make it liquid. So I will show a symbol like this. Okay, this means the reactants are being heated up. 2 atm means 2 atmospheric pressure. That means the reactants are the reaction is taking place under pressure. So pressure at which reaction is carried out, in this case it is 2 atm. Next is pressure. Pressure at which reaction is carried out exceeds normal atmospheric pressure, so we write down this way. Then 0 degree Celsius, here you can write any temperature at which the reaction is taking place. Theek hai, jo temperature pe reaction ho raha hai, agar wo specify karna zaruri hai, to you have to mention it there. Temperature at which reaction is carried out, in this case it is 0 degree Celsius. MnO2 is a catalyst. Okay, there are various catalysts, but MnO2 is commonly used catalyst in various reaction. Now what is a catalyst? I'll just give you a brief idea about it. If there are two reactants reacting with each other in order to give you a product, the reactants ko agar fast reaction karwana hai un dono ke beech mein, to ek catalyst ko add kar diya jata hai, like MnO2, jiske wajah se reaction fast hota hai. MnO2 ka koi role nahi hota, kuch naya product nahi banta MnO2 ka, बट वो सिर्फ हेल्प करता है दोनों रिएक्टेंट्स को फास्ट प्रोसेस करने के लिए ताकि एक नया प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म हो जल्दी से. ठीक है, सो कैटलिस्ट इज ऑल्सो मैंशनड ओवर योर ऑन द एरो. सो फॉर्मूला ऑफ कैटलिस्ट इन दिस केस मैंगनीज ऑक्साइड इज यूज टू ऑल्टर द रेट ऑफ द रिएक्शन. सो दीज नाउ फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट वर्ड इक्वेशन. Now, word equation is very important. It is the basic thing of writing down the equation. Okay? A word equation describes chemical change using the names of the reactants and products. Means, हम लोग directly symbols नहीं use करते हैं, उसका नाम ही use करते हैं in order to write down the equation. Write the word equation for the reactions of methane gas with oxygen gas to form carbon dioxide and water. Now, here, see. It is clearly given to you in this slide. You can see this example. You have to write down the word equation where the reactants and products are mentioned clearly. Means your methane gas is mentioned, oxygen is mentioned, and carbon dioxide and water are mentioned. They are also telling you which is the reactant and which is the product. Okay, so read the question carefully. Write the word equation for the reaction of methane gas with oxygen gas. Matlab, methane and oxygen, they both are reactants. Okay, in which state? They are in the gaseous state. To form carbon dioxide and water means product ki baat ho rahi hai. Product is carbon dioxide and water. So, methane plus oxygen, it gives you carbon dioxide plus water. Now, remember the arrowhead should always be pointing towards the product side. Means it shows that methane and oxygen are giving you carbon dioxide and water. So methane and oxygen are reactants, carbon dioxide and water are products. Okay, this much is clear to everybody out there. Now we can, with the help of the word equation, we can write down the chemical equation proper way. That is, methane ka symbol hai CH4, oxygen ka hai O2. It gives you carbon dioxide ka kya hai CO2. Very good. Plus water ka kya hai H2O. Theek hai? So this is how the chemical equation has to be written. Theek hai? But remember, this is not complete way. We will be learning about that in detail as well. Here we are balancing it. So I hope with this, this part of the chapter was quite clear to you all. In the next coming period, we'll be learning something new and interesting. Till then, thank you. If you liked our session, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can share and view the videos that we had today for you. And please do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you remain updated with all the latest videos that we'll be making for our dear students. This session was quite useful to you. In the next coming period, we'll learn something new and interesting. Till then, thank you.